Welcome to Beeble Rocks.
Hello, Happy New Year, 21. Everything gets better. Jetzt geht's los. Okay, today we, not we, because Konrad is on holiday, I think. Soon he will be back. Today I will talk, I'm happy that I've got my JMP50 back from service. There was not much to do, but we changed, Robert did it, changed the capacitors, the blue guys, I think five of them. Yeah, it's like new. Love it. Of course, with the solo dollars, because that's the perfect match. As I said, that's for me a beautiful clean, especially with the strut. It's exploding. The tones are exploding. And so on. No, that's a real, it's a big sound. And today I experimented a little bit. It takes every pedal well, because for the strut, not bad having something in the back for even more boost. And today I tried it with the Cornish SS3, which is some kind of mild overdrive, but with the possibility for high and low sustained volume, works great. Even the clean comes out better. We'll be right back. little bit smoother, a little bit dirtier. Don't have too much gain. But it's, I think it's enough. No, it's a great combination. You have to get used to it because it can be a little bit bitey, sure, because I don't have the possibility to turn back the tone on the bridge pickup, so it's a bridge pickup. A real Strat bridge pickup. A little bit more compressed sounds, you have to take a guitar with humbuckers. That's a big difference. If you hear an instrument alone, with nothing, no other instrument, no playback, it could be a little bit harsh or whatever, but maybe it fits perfectly in this special mix. So don't make the mistake having always the same full range, bright, deep and mid range all together. Doesn't work, especially if you stack guitars. And that's the most mean part of the sounds, the vintage single coil Strat with a Marshall. I think if I would stand near the box, could be a little bit dangerous. But that's the way it should be. And if I sit this near, it's beginning to get dangerous because of this too near to a transformer or to this electronic stuff. Because I don't have a noise cancelling system in this guitar. For live gigs, I would think about it, especially if it would be the kind of music where you have to be careful with noise, with ballads and pop. But on a real rock, we all remember Jimmy and Richie, they didn't have this. And okay, there was hum and hiss. That doesn't disturb us at all while we are playing. And that's the most important thing after stop playing, turn down the volume because, oh no, that's not bad, but if I would engage a pedal, that's what you get. That should happen every time. No sound, no volume. That belongs together. Dirt, hiss, hum, feedback, healing. That belongs to a real good rock and roll sound sometimes, not always. If I want polished American sounding sounds, I would take the new CCC, or something else, or a different guitar. But that's the real brutal plexi English that we all love. And in the playback, it works out really good. Okay, let's play some solo, some lead about a small piece of music I have here. See you next time, I hope, together with Konrad. We did some, yeah, by the way, we did some really cool camper profiles. We made a profile of the CCC 915, which worked out great, and also, but I think that we have to do again, from the motels, the serviced 50 Marshall, because that's really great in combination with the solar dollars. It doesn't get better. Okay, then, thanks for watching and see you next time.